The government has backed down tonight after a sensational spat with the rail union that saw the entire train network shut down. Transport Minister David Elliott today faced questions on whether he knew about the coming chaos and why commuters were given no warning.
A slow crawl to work in a city not willing to risk riding the rails for fear of being left stranded at the Opal Gates once again.
Please limit travel where possible.
The network-wide train shutdown, which brought Sydney to a standstill, finally over at 5 this morning, with movement at the station after 28 hours of trains sitting idle. But the drastically reduced timetable aimed at sparing passengers more turmoil still made for another frustrating commute.
Normally it would take 40 minutes from Edmondson Park to here. Today it takes around 1 hour 15 minutes.
Yeah, it was a massive delay. I'm on the way to work now. My students have exams. It's terrible and it's not even COVID safe.
An imperfect solution reached in a second consecutive late night decision as the government backed down, allowing drivers back to work. Alleged safety concerns cited by the Premier, Transport Minister and Sydney Trains CEO yesterday apparently evaporated, the union having made no concessions.
How are you feeling heading into this morning's meeting?
Tired. We had a late night meeting with the management last night and we finally got them to see some sense.
And after a showdown at Parliament House with the threat of legal action, the Transport Minister's backdown became an utter capitulation.
The government will withdraw the matter currently before the Fair Work Commission.
The industrial brawl called off, with work now underway to get back to full services.
We've obviously got announcements from the government saying that next week, by Monday, we're going to run a normal timetable. We're fairly confident we can do that.
While the minister and the public await concrete evidence of that safety concern used to justify the drastic shutdown, questions remain about the lack of warning. David Elliott says he didn't find out the plug had been pulled until he woke up on Monday morning.
We pay these people to do their job, and I accept the fact that at 12:43 it was their judgment call. I'm okay that they didn't call me at 12:30 in the morning, yes, because I wouldn't have answered the phone.
The opposition leader taking aim in Parliament.
Is it true that your Chief of Staff sent a text message just before 11 p.m. informing a senior rail bureaucrat that you had been briefed on the major disruption from the looming shutdown and you were said to be comfortable with the decision?
He's obliged now to table any evidence whatsoever to suggest that what I'm saying or what I've been advised is incorrect.
State politics reporter Liz Daniels is live for us at Wynyard Station this evening. Liz, how long will it take for train services to return to normal?
Well, Pete, tonight the wait for a train is still longer than it should be, and it's expected these skeleton services will remain in place for at least the next few days as the union and the government work to scale up with the aim of returning to a full weekday schedule by Monday, Pete.
Liz, thank you.